Hello everyone and welcome to the very fourth episode of our Pinehill Zoo project. Today we are going to do the second part of Peafowl Gardens, so the gardens that are in the main entries of the zoo, and it's going to be a little finisher of this project of this part of the zoo. So I'm really happy to show you that one today. So the first thing we're gonna do, the thing that is currently on the screen, is making a some sort of a modernistic planter that is made out completely from flexicolor planks. And inspiration for this one came from Pinterest when I saw a very similar planter, but not the same, because as always I like to give a little twist to the inspiration I got from Pinterest, of course, and because that is the main source of my Plan Zoo building inspiration and my architecture. And I really recommend downloading that one and having fun searching for certain items on it. And the original one was slightly darker, made out of completely different wood, but the plant choice was pretty similar. Maybe there weren't any nettles, because they are really harmful for humans. But as the planet zoo fauna choice goes, I didn't have anything nicer to put into a typical European kind of planter, so I chose nettles. And as you can see, I'm experimenting with putting some few more flowers in the planter and some more nettles on the top, but in the end I didn't like it, so I left it how it is, and there was a little jump in time, and now I'm putting more planters of this type to make some sort of a wall blocking the view of the staff backstage that is going to be in here in a few minutes. We're going to start building it pretty soon on the video, of course. And now it looks very repetitive when it comes to plants that are in the planter, but off screen I changed the placement of some bigger plants that are in this planter. They are called alpine something. Like, I didn't know how to call those dwarf. I still don't know how they are called, dwarf cornel or something like that. Those white flowers. And yeah, so that was the end of my planter part. And I must say that this part is very laggy. Whenever I want to place something there, my game just lags and stops working, so that's not nice at all. And now we are doing a security gate. And this one was inspired by nothing. I think it was like my own choice of materials here and how I wanted it to look. So you have a little checkpoint where you can scan your card, ID card, so you can access the staff backstage and go to the further buildings that will be in the next episode, or in next few episodes, I don't know when I will start them. And this, what you can see right now on the screen, is the foundation for the first part of this building column that will be in the staff backstage, and it's going to be a little gardener's shed that where gardener can keep his tools and some seeds and, you know, good stuff to make plants healthy. Some wheelbarrows, some sacks with dirt or mulch, I don't know, whatever. And it's going to be an integral part of the bigger building that will be closer to the river, and it's going to be Wildlife Rehabilitation Center. And this one will be inspired by Białowieża National Park, because I really love that one. And someone on my first video actually commented that, I must say it was my friend, that it looks like Białowieża Park, the entrance to the zoo, but to be honest, it doesn't, because there is no such modern building in Białowieża, but yeah, maybe he was making a little joke. But actually this building is inspired by something that is in the main headquarters of Białowieża National Park. So they have like that wooden building next to their main headquarters, and I'm going to post a picture, I think, somewhere now on the screen, and you can see that on the left there is that wooden building. Maybe it doesn't look the same as the one I'm doing right now, because as I said, I like to give buildings my own twist, so it's much smaller, there aren't any metal framings as in that one, but the supports are pretty similar to those ones that are on this visible on this terrace that's on the main building. So now I can talk a bit about Białowieża and why I chose that park, because the Pinehill needed a place that will be something older, somewhat older, so it's not going to be all modern, so it's going to have that older part where the animals that have wild animals that have some problems with their health will be kept and rehabilitated. So yeah, and making it some more rustic looking and all of that will like give an illusion that it was there before the grand renovation of the zoo, so it was there for some time now and it looks some more rustic, and I don't know, I really like that project, and it will be a little moment for me to forget about the modern style and like experiment with those stone and wooden pieces I really love. So now we are doing a peafowl coop, so as chickens have their coops, now my peafowls will have them too. So the door you currently see on the screen are too small for the peafowls to go in, so off screen I made a little enhancement to the door so they are bigger and they are better, and peafowls can really access their indoor area that will be built on screen in some time. You will see I did some nice things with it. And now we are putting the doors for gardener to enter the shed, so he can move his wheelbarrow through them and, you know, all good stuff. And a little light switch to make like automatized doors, so he clicks it and the door open, and a little wire made out of course, New World lamps on the wire, because it looks really nice when it's put upside down. And now will be some sort of more boring part, because this will be a door placement, so we have some doors, so the staff in real life could access the whole building and move through it. And in the meantime, I can say one thing that is now visible, that the peafowls, the building is called Peafowl Gardens, you know, but actually I should call it Peafowl Backstage or something like that, because the peafowls found a way to escape when they are in the main gardens, and they are escaping through the benches that I made, those custom benches, and it's there is no way to prevent them from doing so. I tried elephant grass put upside down, but it didn't work. I tried some a few more things and it didn't work too, so I gave up and just closed them in this backstage, but it looks good, and I made such a fence that it looks like they in real life they could pass it and go to the gardens, but in the game they will stay in here and simply be here, you know, have a great life. And now we are doing the entrance for chicken coop, for peafowl coop, and as you can see I'm doing a little ramp and I'm putting some few more planks on it, because when I think about coop I see like this ramp that has some additional planks, because when I think it's because of that when chicken goes on that ramp it needs some sort of support to have something to put his feet on it, so it doesn't slip off the ramp, and it's like a little realistic choice. And now we are in the inside of the peafowl coop, and we are doing some supports to make the construction look more steady and all of that, and it's going to be pretty repetitive because I don't know whether in zoo there will be some sort of beautiful and very randomized backstage for animals, because no one other than a zookeeper and animal will ever see this part. So yeah, it's like some wooden frames on which there will be some bedding so the peafowls can sleep on it. And I actually must say that they use all of those pieces in here, and that's pretty satisfying to watch. And yeah, they will have nothing else basically in the interior part for them, but they use it, and they do use it a lot, I must say, because they spend like half of the time in there sleeping and chilling. And as you can see, I made a little inside area for the gardener off screen, because I didn't think it was as very interesting for you guys to watch. So I did it off screen. And it's made out of few sacks laying here and there, and a few like metal frames, so metal shelves, so the gardener can keep his stuff on them. And now I'm experimenting with the roof, and I must say the roof that is currently on the screen and will be like in the end of this part of the video won't get accepted by me. I don't like it, and after the jump in time it will be a completely different roof. Because yeah, I wanted to make it straight, not so fancy, you know, it's like an older building but renovated a bit. So now we are doing some supports to make the construction look more more interesting to watch, because guests actually have a little peek at the staff backstage, because I think it's sometimes nice to watch the staff backstage like function and see peafowls going from here and there. So yeah, that's why I kept it open for the guests. And those supports are, as I said before, inspired by Białowieża Zoo. Not Białowieża Zoo, Białowieża National Park. And in the future episodes I'm going to talk more about Białowieża, so keep an eye for that if you want to know more about that beautiful place, as I think it's one of the best places for wildlife observation in the Poland. So yeah, as you can see, now we are doing a little stone wall, which to be honest isn't inspired by Białowieża. It's just the foundation of the building. I took out the foundation and made it higher and more and randomized the bricks, so it doesn't look that bad. And yeah, I think it suits the more older theme. And now is the little barrier that I was talking about. So the peafowls can't get through it, but it looks like in real life they could just go below the rope and go to the gardens themselves. But it in the game it prevents them from doing so. So now a little border, a little bit of terrain painting, and some plants. And as you can see, now we can use plants that I used in the previous episode for forest planter in the more normal environment. So it looks like a part of Pinehill forest, so pretty random without any mulch on the ground, maybe some dirt texture, but it would be there because yeah, it is forest, so it has some random materials on the ground. And now I'm placing a few trees, and I didn't like how that big tree sticked out, and just it had all of guests' attention when looking from the start of Peafowl Gardens, so I wanted to prevent that. And now instead of that big pine, there is an oak sapling, so it looks more like it, like more. It's still like a wildlife choice, but not that vibrant and not that big. And now there we are coming to the end of the video, so we are going to put some fence here and there and make it look like an exhibit. And you can see I'm putting a normal fence in here, and there are two reasons behind it. The first one is that I wanted to prevent peafowls from escaping. That's the one. And the other one is that I wanted to start a foundation for the future rehabilitation enclosures for animals, so where they will be kept. And so as it is the end of the video, I will leave you guys in here, and I can say that it was a real pleasure to talk to you and speak to you in the next episode. So goodbye.